Now, the Philippine Stock Exchange Index carrying on with its sideways trading. Volumes have remained extremely low, says Chris Mangan of AAA Equities. He expects to see the index continue higher and test the 5850 resistance, the red line there, before the end of the week. The index is likely to carry on with its sideways trade in the next few weeks, with support at 5350 and resistance at 5950. The index kicks off trading from above 5555. As for the currency pair, the peso continues to trade sideways just as well, volatility causing what Chris describes as minor flukes. Expected with all the uncertainty in the current environment. Chris sees more volatility in the coming months. Main support remains at 50.42 the dollar, the lower black line there, while main resistance is at 51.40. The peso starts trading at 50.72 the dollar. Well, with us now for more is Chris himself, the head of research at AAA Securities. Good to see you, Chris. Welcome back to the program.
Good morning, Kathy. Thanks for having me.
Right. So how are markets kicking off trading?
Yeah, well, right now, it looks like we opened slightly lower after yesterday's gains. Right now, I really think that the uncertainty is driving investors away, and that's evident in the abysmal trading volumes that we're seeing every day. Turnover value is about $3.5 billion, which is just half of what the normal daily trading volume is. So, I really think that all this uncertainty is driving investors away from the market. I think we're seeing a risk-off appetite. Market has been trading sideways for the last couple of weeks, but from the looks of it, it looks like it wants to go lower. So we'll just have to see what external factors are going to improve or maybe affect this sentiment in a negative way.
Yeah, but one could take a sideways move as something more positive than a downtrend, wouldn't it?
Yes, as much as I would like to believe it, the longer when markets move sideways, it's building momentum for a bigger move. Now, whether it's to the upside or to the downside, that remains to be seen. We only know that once it happens. But from the looks of how our market is trading, it looks like it wants to go lower. When the market started moving higher from its bottom a couple of months ago, I think there was some, I think we already hit the euphoria stage. I think the market rose too fast. And because of that, we're going to see some profit taking, and we're going to see some investors take some cash off the table, especially since everybody's expecting second quarter numbers to be worse than the first. So I do see some downside in this market. I don't think it's going to retest the current bottoms. I don't think we're going to go that low, but I think things are going to be slow for a while.
Now, twists and turns in the franchise saga surrounding ABS-CBN. Shares closed down 2.2%, extending losses from after they resumed trading on Monday. What have you done with your positions on the stock since?
Well, I think most investors are on a wait and see mode as well. There's a lot of confusion on what's going to happen with that franchise, and I think investors are waiting. The shares of the stock performed better than most expected it to fare, and I think everybody's waiting on what's going to happen with these hearings on that franchise. Now, if the company loses that franchise, there's no way to sugarcoat it. That's going to be terrible for the stock's performance. That's going to be extremely bearish. But I think most investors are on a wait and see mode. The thing about ABS shares is they're thinly traded. There isn't a lot of shares out there in the public, so that's why we're not seeing as much volatility. But we'll just have to see how these hearings play out in the next few weeks, whether there's a lot of back and forth between the House of Representatives and the NTC on that matter. And we'll just have to see how that plays out.
Final point, Chris, what's the deal with Macroasia? It's one of the stocks you're looking at, a provider of aviation-related support services. Share price up 29%. When all planes are grounded, how did that happen?
Well, yesterday we did see it hit a new 52-week low. Now, every time, even in the market sense, every time a stock or the market hits a bottom, you do see a kind of a bounce. And that's what we saw on Macro Asia yesterday. Shares were up almost 30%. I think that's just knee-jerk reaction to what the company is actually worth. They're still hurting. There's no, their main business is aircraft maintenance and catering, so they're not doing any business. They were supposed to develop Sangley Point with their Chinese partners. I think that's been put on hold as well. But I think investors are just riding this minor bounce from its new low yesterday. So there are still opportunities in this market for seasoned traders, despite the low volumes and despite that negative sentiment. And that's what we saw in Macro Asia.
All right. Well, keep watching for those stocks for us, Chris. I appreciate it. You keep well, as always. Chris Mangan of AAA Equities.